All right, let's run. You guys should know. Okay. Floyd Landis explaining
so
how to get away with doping. So no, me, just kidding.
Yeah,
sorry,
I'll
Floyd.
Help you with that.
Are the jokes allowed or not?
Of course. So, just as a baseline understanding, hemp is where we get the CBD from, and hemp is cannabis that's got less than 0.3% THC. That's just a regulatory threshold that determines whether cannabis is hemp or marijuana. And so you can extract, as you would with marijuana, you can extract the oils from the bud, the flower part of it, and then you have a what we call a full spectrum oil, and it does have trace amounts of THC in it. So we have a line that we put black labels on it, and it says full spectrum, and it's got 600 milligrams of CBD in this particular bottle, but it does have trace amounts of THC in it. And some people are completely averse to that, or work in as an airline pilot or something like that, have a theoretical risk of using that. The other stuff.
So you can have CBD without THC.
Yeah, so there's a way to take the oil and then isolate the THC and turn it into, it just ends up being, it's a chemical process, it ends up being just a white powder, like you, and then you could add it to things just as you would caffeine or something, right? So that's what we make most of this stuff out of. So these, we have like a protein recovery mix. It's got 25 milligrams of isolate in it, and there's zero THC or any other compounds from hemp, and it's just pure CBD. And we make a couple flavors of those, and we make a hydration mix. Some people like a small amount of CBD before a workout. They feel like it...
It helps relax them, or do
it
helps pain,
you focus,
or what?
I think it's more of a focus thing. Like, it helps you...
I could not be ADD if I took this stuff in the morning?
So it really helps with that, actually, and it helps people that can't sleep at night for that reason. Like, when your mind's running at night, it doesn't make you tired, but if you take it at night, it has this just kind of calming, subtle calming feeling in it. It's actually a really nice just sleep aid. But like,
yeah,
I said, it doesn't make you tired. It's just more of a, helps you manage your thoughts. I'll be interested in hearing what you think of it if you try it out. And then we have a couple different variations. We have a topical. So this one's got the black label too. So it has very small amounts of THC in it. And this is 50 milligrams. A good dose if you're taking it orally is 25 to 50 milligrams.
And this just to sort of help you be calm, or like recovery, or both? Or?
Both. It helps with pain and like I don't want to oversell it,
right?
Because people then will think I'm crazy, but it has a couple very, very noticeable effects. One is it helps manage pain, and the other is that it helps just focus and calms your mind. And it's a noticeable effect too.
So you take it every day?
I do, yeah. I really like it.
But you take a pill and the liquid. And
so the what's in the pill and what's in the tincture is exactly the same thing. It's just more economical to make it this way because we don't have to put it into a gel capsule, right? So some people buy this because it's slightly less expensive. It tastes like, I mean, it's oil. It tastes like marijuana, so some people don't like the taste. But then once you have the isolate, you can put it into other things. Like, this is a transdermal cream that we make using a pharmaceutical grade base that works surprisingly well. I was skeptical at first, but we have...
So, like, my back hurts. Put that on there?
Yeah. It doesn't work for everybody all the time. If it's going to work for the kind of pain you're using it on, it'll work in 15 minutes, you'll know. Probably two or three pumps of it, and just rub it on and around the area where it hurts. And we've had amazing feedback from that stuff.
What are these little gels?
And these are just more, like, warm-up and rubs for sports, right? They smell. They have more of a smell. This doesn't have any smell to it. These are like there's an arnica one, there's like a warming one, it's got a spice in it. This one's arnica. People like different, you know, herbal topicals. I'm not, you know, not a huge fan of them, but it's big in cycling, especially people like kind of.
Yeah, so I guess cycling's more your thing, but in terms of running, I mean, also, like, I guess you have two businesses. You have this thing in, you sell like weed, people can smoke it,
yeah,
whatever,
yeah.
Like. That's in Leadville, or that's in Denver too? Like, it seems like Leadville.
So we have
tiny...
a store. We have a store in Leadville, then we have three stores in Portland,
Oregon.
Portland, Oregon, yeah. And
Leadville's
small,
nowhere,
but
right?
Yeah, but it's a decent place to have a dispensary because in Colorado they left the local jurisdictions with the option whether they want to allow it or not, and so there's quite a few towns south of Leadville that don't allow marijuana, so we get business from those towns. So it's not a bad spot to have a store.
And could you? I mean, sort of being in a regulated industry could be good or bad, but, like, if they can keep out your competitors, that'd be great. But, like,
yeah.
Like, can you go open up in Denver, or everybody's already in Denver, so there's
no
point?
You can, and there's a market for licenses. I mean, there's still some new licenses.
There's only so many licenses that they give out.
So that depends as well, that on a given city or a given county, that the local jurisdiction or municipality can limit it. So Denver didn't necessarily limit initially. Now I think there's some limits to it, but you can buy and sell these licenses. So yeah, we could do it in Denver.
And the money, is it's hard to like put in the banking system still, or is that still
kinda... Yeah, it's complicated. And there are some banks that will bank with marijuana businesses in Colorado, but it's the cost is really high. So a lot
and can of you keep the CBD? Is the CBD the same business or is it separate business?
No, we keep it completely separate because the cost of, I mean, the regulatory cost of growing marijuana is very high because they just the amount of paperwork and surveillance, they want to track where this, how much you grew all the way to where it was sold because they don't want the federal government saying, hey, the state of Colorado doesn't know how to manage this, right? So there's a lot of cost to it. Whereas on the hemp side, when we grow hemp, we have a little bit of regulatory cost on the farming side of it when we grow it, but after that, it doesn't have the tracking system.
So hemp's a completely different crop, but it has THC in it.
And it's regulated completely differently, yeah. Okay. As long as it has less than 0.3% THC by dry weight when you harvest it, then it's called hemp. So you can, there's also farming anomalies.
Do people smoke hemp?
Yeah, they do. The really high quality stuff, you can smoke it, and it's, if you smoke CBD flower, it's nice. I mean, like, it's a nice, relaxing feeling.
So long term, do you think the CBD part's going to be much bigger? I mean, I feel like you could... One, you're not limited to location, right?
Yeah.
Well, eventually, so marijuana may be legal everywhere in America, but it's not.
It'll be a while, yeah.
But there's a huge market for performance athletes or
anyone
with pain or, like, whatever it is, right? Like, you don't have to be an athlete, right? I mean, like,
right,
my
exactly.
mom is... She probably consumes more Advil than the rest of us.
We'll have to get her some CBD. But, yeah, I mean, look, they're both... I like both sides of it. I like the marijuana side. I mean, it's a funny crowd. It's people that really like marijuana, and so it's a whole new experience for me. But I enjoy marijuana once in a while. Not every day. I don't feel like I get much done if I'm high. But I do like the dispensary side of it. But the CBD side has taken a lot of our time lately, just because it's done quite well and it's meaningful. Like it really does help people. I mean,
so the marijuana side, you guys have to grow the plant yourselves. You can't buy them from someone else.
There's a liquid market for that as well, but that's within a regulated framework where it has to be transported by a certain, you know, licensed operation to another licensed operation, and there's a tracking system, and it's complex.
I feel like if they can track these plants, we should be able to have better anti-doping.
Maybe you could put those guys from the alcohol and tobacco agency
put them in charge. Didn't Jeff Nowitzki go into something else?
Yeah, that was sketchy as well, right? Now he's in charge of the anti-doping at MMA, which I'm sure is all cleaned up now.
Probably gets paid a lot better, though.
Yeah, I don't fault him for that, but yeah.